இலங்கை நாடாளுமன்றத்தில் நடைபெறவுள்ள நம்பிக்கை வாக்கெடுப்பில் ராஜபக்சே கண்டிப்பாக தோல்வியடைவார் என ரணில் விக்ரமசிங்கே நம்பிக்கை தெரிவித்துள்ளார். நியூஸ் 18 தொலைக்காட்சிக்கு அவர் அளித்த பிரத்யேக பேட்டியில் எம்பிக்களுக்கு பல கோடி ரூபாய் லஞ்சம் வழங்க ராஜபக்சே தரப்பு முயலுவதாகவும் குற்றம் சாட்டியுள்ளார்.
இலங்கையில் அரசியல் நெருக்கடி நிலை ஏற்பட்டிருக்கிற இந்த வேளையில் நம்மிடம் சபாநாயகரால் அங்கீகரிக்கப்பட்ட பிரதமர் ரணில் விக்ரமசிங்கே இருக்கிறார். அவரிடம் நாம் தற்போது உரையாடலாம். ஐயா வணக்கம். According to the numbers, do you think you can really prove your majority if parliament convened today?
According to the speaker, the other side has to prove their majority because we have already shown a majority.
So if vote of confidence happened, do you believe he will be defeated?
He will be defeated.
So do you think it's tactics adopted by Mr. Sirisena and Rajabaksha to postpone the session to gain their support by doing horse trade?
They are trying to do horse trade, but public pressure has forced them to advance it from the 16th to 14th. Okay. That's not enough, but anyway you can see the pressure is working.
According to your knowledge, how much is being paid to your MPs by your opponents?
Various sums are mentioned, 200, 300 million.
So, TNA has now 15 MPs. What is your assurance to them to win their support?
No, we have always said that there must be reconciliation, a political solution. We have to consider their requests, and many of them may be acceptable, some are not. And we've been working together with them. Also on the development of the North and the East, we have been consistent in our policy.
But ministers like Vadivel Suresh and Mattakalappu MP Vyalendran, they are saying that in your 3-year position, you have not done anything to the tea plantation workers and the war widows.
We have given them ownership of land and they are also building houses for them. That has happened everywhere. We have a separate ministry in charge of it. So that is not there. Batiklo we are also developing. And there is a lot of development taking place in Batiklo and the eastern province. And our focus now is on the Jaffna and the northern province, which require more attention.
So before this political crisis, you and Mr. Rajabaksha visited India separately. It's being pointed out that beginning of this crisis, it is true.
He had visited India on invitation, I think by Subramaniam Swami, to address some conference. I had pre-arranged this about 3-4 months ago and visited India after we finished the Indian Ocean Conference in Vietnam and the Freedom on Navigation Conference here in Sri Lanka. These were my one was pre-planned long before anyone else.
So, as soon as Rajabaksha was announced as the Prime Minister, a BJP person, Mr. Subramanian Sami, Member of Parliament in India, he is the first one to applaud this decision. So, do you think India is backing his, or India is welcoming Mr. Rajabaksha?
Mr. Subramanian Sami acts on his own. BJP always says that is not their view.
So, do you think this current political crisis in Sri Lanka can be seen as, can be related with geopolitical politics?
I won't say that. I think it's internal politics here. But it will have its impact on geopolitical situation.
So, some are saying that this fight, this war between you and Mr. Rajabaksha should be seen as the fight between India and China to win control over Sri Lanka. It is true?
No, I don't see that way. So, we have friendly relations with all.
So, before this political crisis break, a major Indian newspaper reported that Mr. Sirisena had said that he is being targeted by Indian spy agency. Later, he denied that statement. But how do you see this whole drama?
Well, after that, there was the President Sirisena had rung up Prime Minister Modi and explained it, so let it rest at that.
In yesterday's protest, Sirisena had said that he has already achieved 130 MP support. So, do you believe that?
If he has 130, he should summon parliament this week.
he also said that you are not taking decision on your own, but you are doing taking decision by the statement from the butterfly gangs.
I don't know what those are. I don't know what the gangs are. I take decisions with the relevant ministers or with the UNF, United National Front High Command, the leaders of the UNF, sometimes the leaders of the UNP, the main party in the UNF.
So
all decisions are taken, otherwise we have discussed the matters also with President, and all decisions are taken in Cabinet.
So finally, what is your message to the international Tamil community?
My message to the Tamil community, like the Muslims and the Sinhalese, all, our democracy must prevail for a final solution to Sri Lanka's issues, both reconciliation in the north and the east, economic development, political. We made good progress from 2015. All that can be lost by one reckless act of the president.
Also,
parliamentary democracy must prevail.
Also, in yesterday's protest, Sirisena said that you tried to make rift between India and him. It is true.
I have not tried to make any rift between India and him.
Thank you very much, sir. ஓ நிச்சயமாக நம்பிக்கை வாக்கெடுப்பு நடக்கும் பட்சத்தில் ராஜபக்சே தரப்பு தன்னை பெரும்பான்மையை உறுதி செய்வதற்கான எண்ணிக்கை அவரிடம் இல்லை என பிரதமர் ரணில் விக்ரமசிங்கே தெரிவித்துள்ளார். இலங்கையிலிருந்து ஒளிப்பதிவாளர் ஸ்ரீராமுடன் சதீஷ், நியூஸ் 18 தமிழ்நாடு.